Hey, it's Dave, Fisheng Products. Today we're gonna put a little rail system in my buddy Darren's boat. He's got a little 18-foot Aluma Weld Free Drifter. So we're just gonna simply attach this bar to the side of this. It's very straightforward. We put a spacer behind it. We start at the front and we do one hole at a time coming back. So we'll try to do this in sequence, but we'll just simply C-clamp this to the side, drill the holes, tap them. We have a drill with a tap and one with the drill, and we just simply pop them on one hole at a time, and we use thread locker on the stainless screws going into the aluminum, and then when we get it installed, we'll come back and put the rubber on top. We've pre-drilled the first hole. We have our spacer behind it and do one hole at a time. We ran our tap through there, and we're simply going to just put red Loctite thread locker on the threads, and then simply just install the first fastener up there, and we'll just simply work our way all the way down the rail. Just give it a good snug up in there, and then just keep working back and put one spacer in at a time. And remember, leave this aluminum about a quarter inch low from this surface, because when you put the rubber on, it's gonna come up a quarter of an inch. So leave this about a quarter inch low, keep working your way back. We'll catch up with you when we get four or five more holes. Hey, so we're at a transition point here. We've got our first 12 feet installed here. Normally we sell this in 6-foot chunks, because that way we can ship it from the post office. But since Darren lives local, we just do it in 12-foot strips. So we got a 12-foot, and then we got a 39-inch piece to finish it up here. And this transition will look absolutely seamless when we put the rubber on top. So literally it took us 20 minutes maybe to do this 12-foot, to drill and tap it. You got a drill with your pilot drill. You got your drill with the threads. You got your thread locker and your spacers. And it simply just keeps going along, you know, and then we'll get this one on, and then we'll show you how to put the rubber on. So we got the aluminum all installed down the side of the boat. Now we're starting to cap it with the rubber. Pretty straightforward process. Just start it on the bottom, lift it up on there, and I get these little pry bars from Harbor Freight. You could use a screwdriver or anything, and just simply just keep working it back as you go, and it goes pretty quick. And just keep feeding it on from the bottom, and you're good to go. Hey, it's Dave, Fisheng Products here. We got Darren's boat done. Took us probably about an hour and a half, 2 hours maybe at the max. Got the rail system installed, got the rod stations put on, got the sliders put in. You can see it came out pretty awesome. Looks like it came on the boat, and all factory, and like, you know, it's not added on. Rods will be protected with the rubber. You accidentally lean it up against there, so you got that. It's more comfortable to lean on. And anyway, super simple, hour and a half, 2 hours, and we had an 18-foot boat done.